Welcome back to another episode of Who the F***. God, I'm really stuffed up. This is not good. It's the show that aims to take a deep dive into some of the acts announced for Reading and Leeds 2019. In today's video, we're looking at Dreamers. They're a pop rock band from Manhattan, New York, United States of America. If you've never heard of them before, hopefully this video will help answer the question, who the f*** are Dreamers? All I needed was to hear the truth. I'm lying naked and my brain has lost its truth. Nick, Nelson and Jacob are the three members that make up Dreamers. They're a pop rock band from New York City. Well, Wikipedia describes them as pop rock slash alternative rock. They remind me of people like Foster the People. Imagine Dragons. MGMT. Now let's have some fun. They formed in New York in 2004. They formed in New York in 2014. Following the dissolution of the band Motive, lead singer Nick and then drummer Chris would meet bassist Mark, although he doesn't even like to be referred to as his surname, so Nelson. They'd released their debut single Wolves, You've Got Me, in 2014. You got me brainwashed, you got me so lost. Which would be included in their debut self-titled EP. This was released on Fairfax Records. In February of 2015, they would go on to sign a full record deal with Fairfax Records and relocated to Los Angeles. It was at this point that Jacob would join the band and Chris would leave. In August of 2016, they would release their debut album entitled Does Not Exist. And in July of 2018, they would release a trilogy of EP. The first one was entitled Launch. It's a four-track EP where the artwork features the Falcon 9 SpaceX rocket taking off with a slightly purple hue. The next part of the trilogy was the EP Fly, a five-track EP. The artwork on this one would have more of a kind of spaceship console or aircraft console as the artwork. And in February of 2019, they would release the single Die Happy, of which fans would assume would be from the third and final EP of the trilogy. However, the band actually announced they're releasing their second album, Launch Fly Land, and will be released in April in 2019. Previously, they've been on tour with bands like the Stone Temple Pilots, the Airborne Toxic Event, The Vaccines, Weezer, Catfish and the Bottlemen, All Time Low, The Main, and Yumi at Six. Now, in addition to Fairfax, it says on their website, that on their Wikipedia page, they're also signed to Hollywood Records. Hollywood are a subsidiary of Disney Music Group, so not one of the major three, but I'm not quite sure you could describe it as independent. But all of their releases seem to be on Fairfax, so I don't know if that means it's published by them or they've funded some part of their recording process, but I can't seem to find a website for Hollywood Records to confirm this. Their most popular song is the record Sweet Disaster. Currently sat on 1.7 million views on YouTube, and this is their first time playing Reading and Leeds. They're playing in between Bad Child and No Rome on the Festival Republic stage on the Friday at Reading, Saturday at Leeds. And you know, I actually quite like them. The fact they've got pop in their title would suggest that I wouldn't, but I do. I really do quite like their sound. I'll be honest, I saw that they had an affliction with Disney and just instantly got turned off. I've got to change my opinion on this independent record stuff because all the music I love is signed by major record labels, so I've just got to let that go. And I couldn't help but feel they're a little bit Disney Channel. But the more I listen to their music, the more I enjoy it. The algorithm has now kicked in, and it recommends it to me when I'm listening to other music on YouTube, so... And I don't hate that. Currently, it looks like they're going to be clashing with the Night Cafe, but if I'm over towards that way, following No Rome or waiting for Bad Child... Oh, by the way, Bad Child I'm enjoying a lot more now. Then I can see myself catching quite a bit of their set. As I said, quite like them. Not to a point where I'm going to start adding them to my library and listening to them on the regular, but I don't despise them by any means. So on the likely to see scale, I'm going to go with a 4 out of 10. What do you think? Are you excited to check out their set? Have you seen them perform before? You know, I think that it's interesting to see a band, like an indie band's doing good in the pop world. There is this slight kind of Disney Channel sound to them, but I don't think it's as like neatly polished as a lot of what you would expect it to be. So perhaps I just wish I never saw that they had any affliction with the Disney Channel. I'd probably enjoy them a lot more. I'd love to know what you have to say. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below as always, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers. Bye.